welcome you to join us today as we learn about what's in a name. And so far, we've learned that through Jesus and God's names, names are powerful and important. Names help us to separate us from one another and help us to recognize how important we are as God's children. So today's name we are learning is Jesus is the Prince of Peace. So Judy, have you ever felt the big stress of when you take a big test at school and then after you take it, you suddenly feel the weight of the world off your shoulders and then you finally feel like you can relax?
Hey kids, yes, I have definitely felt like that for many tests. But there's nothing quite like the feeling of relief once your test is done and you can just relax and think about other things.
That's very true. Kids, have you ever felt that way after you take a big test? I know I did when I was still in school. Jesus wants us to know as Prince of Peace that he is our comforter, he is our helper, and he is our protector when we're facing greatest challenges in our lives as children of God. There's a great example in the Bible when God encouraged the people of Israel and Judah through the prophet Isaiah. God wanted the people to know that even though they were going through difficult times, that God would be sending through the Prince of Peace, Jesus, soon. And you know what God did? Jesus came and he brings us peace. What a wonderful gift we have in Jesus. He even says in John 14, verse 27, I am leaving you with a gift, peace of mind and peace of heart. And the peace that I give you is a gift the world cannot give. So do not be troubled or afraid.
Kids, since Jesus has power over earth, heaven, and all other things, we can be encouraged in knowing that we can do all things through Christ who gives us strength. We hope that you enjoy this week's lesson as we learn about Jesus, the Prince of Peace. Next up, we're going to head over to our activity.
Everyone, welcome to activity time. Today's activity is quite simple, but it's a lot of fun. So, there are three things you're going to need. You're going to need a lunch bag filled with water, some pencils to use, and you can do this activity over a sink or over a bucket. Now, make sure that the plastic is completely sealed. So when you turn it upside down, no water is coming through. All right. So, take the pencil, what you're going to do, push through very hard, and out on the other side. And then you're going to do it again, and again, and again. So, while I'm busy doing that, I'm going to explain to you why I'm showing this activity. Sometimes in life, these pencils represent unexpected situations. You know, things that maybe you don't notice, maybe it is noticeable, but you're not sure how to handle it. And things sometimes come without you even realizing it's happening. Now, what's going to happen is as I pull the pencils out, the water is going to overflow. And sometimes that can happen. Unexpected things happen. And look how all this water is coming out. You see? And it's flowing and overflowing and overflowing. Just pull them out quickly and as fast as you can. There we go. And sometimes when things go crazy, this bag could be you. And you don't know what's going on. But guess what? This bucket represents Jesus. And he's the Prince of Peace. And that's what we're focusing on today. So kids, when you're going through tough times, know that Jesus is going to catch you when you fall. And he is always there for you. Thank you so much for joining us for activity time. Up next is a time of praising Jesus.
Up, knowing there's a reason, all my dreams come alive. Life is for living with you. I made my decision. You lift me up, fill my eyes with wonder. Forever young in your love, this freedom's untainted. With you, no moment is wasted. Sun now bursting through the clouds, black and white, turn to color all around. All is new in the Savior I am found. Oh, this is living now.
nothing like living with you. This life you created, I choose. See the sun now bursting through the clouds, black and white, turn to color all around. All is new in the Savior I am found. This is living now. Living now.
Get ready for today's story of a few disciples who had a stormy turn of events. An amazing Savior, Jesus Christ, who helped them find peace. You can find this story in Luke 8, verse 22 to 25. Let's begin. One day, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let's cross to the other side of the lake." So they got into a boat and started out. As they sailed across, Jesus settled down for a nap. Soon, a huge and fierce storm came upon the lake. The waves were huge and the boat was filling with water quickly. They were in real danger. The disciples ran down to where Jesus was sleeping and woke him up, shouting, "Master, Master, we are going to drown." When Jesus woke up, he scolded the wind and the raging waves. Suddenly, the storm stopped and all was calm. Then he asked them, "Where is your faith?" The disciples were terrified and amazed. "Who is this man?" they asked each other. "When he gives a command, even the wind and the waves obey him."
Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed today's Bible story, the story about Jesus calming the storms and the waves. We saw in this Bible story how the disciples lost their faith and their peace when the storm and the winds arose, even when Jesus was with them in the boat. I want to know from you today, have you ever felt that way? Have you ever maybe felt that Jesus didn't quite understand what you were going through? Or maybe it felt as though he wasn't there? I want to assure you today that he does indeed understand everything that we're going through. In fact, that he loves us so much that he gave his life for us, that we may be made right with the Father. And also, that Jesus was himself a man. Therefore, he understands really what we're going through. He too was tried with difficulties and overcame. So Jesus, the Prince of Peace, is with us today, and he wants to offer peace to you as well, so that you could live even through the winds and the waves, knowing that he is there and that he cares for you. So today's memory verse, I'm going to have Sean, my friend, help me out. All right, so here we go. Isaiah 9, verse 6. "For a child unto us is given, a son unto us is born. The governments shall rest upon his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace." Right, let's bow our heads and let's pray. Heavenly Father, we've come to you today and we are grateful, Father, that you understand what we go through. And whatever we go through, we are never alone. Help us to have peace in every situation and to walk with that and let it be contagious to everybody we encounter. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Go. even gone to win my war. Your love becomes my greatest defense. It leads me from the dry wilderness, and all I did was praise. And all I did was worship.
Thank you so much for joining us today as we looked at the mighty, powerful name of Jesus, which is known as the Prince of Peace. We were encouraged by the story of Jesus calming the storm, that when he spoke to the winds and the waves, they calmed down, just like that. We can see the mighty power of Jesus, that even the winds and the waves obeyed him. As you go into next week, kids, be encouraged that you can call on the Prince of Peace, and he will be there to comfort your heart, to guide you, protect you, and help you in any situations that you are facing as a child of God. Always remember that Jesus has overcome the world, and he will give you strength to be strong in him.
Hey Bex, you're never going to believe the amazing news I have today.
What's the amazing news, Tiana?
Well, Rachel from our Harvest family, who's in grade R, has decided to give her life to Jesus.
Oh my goodness, that's amazing.
It really is. So Rachel, we just want to congratulate you, and we can't wait to see the amazing works that Jesus is going to do in your life. Kids, we have such an amazing challenge for you as well. Please draw us a picture of Jesus calming the waves and send it to us at kids@harvest.co.za because we are going to feature some of your beautiful drawings in next week's lesson. Also, if you'd like to message Bella and tell her about any of your questions, she would love to hear from you. So kids, go in God's grace, mercy, and love, and we'll see you next week. Bye.
Bye.